Hello, in this tutorial I will explain the controls to manually drive a spaceship in free flight mode. In order to enter free flight mode, you must be selecting a planet or moon, and be close enough to it to be inside its gravitational sphere of influence. When you are close enough to the planet or moon, the free flight mode button will appear at the lower right of the screen. Tap it and so many buttons will appear to allow you to select the type of spaceship you want to use. You can tap it again to make those buttons disappear. To enter free flight mode, decide which type of spaceship you want to control and tap on its button. Keep in mind that some buttons may be disabled if you haven't upgraded to the full version of the app. When you enter free flight mode, you will see the selected spaceship just in front of you. The spaceship will start in freefall towards the selected planet, so the first thing that you should do is to put it into a stable orbit. But first, let's have a look at the information and controls you will see on the screen. At the left part of the screen, below the spaceship level, you will see all the relevant information related to the free flight mode. Distance refers to the distance from the camera to the spaceship. Delta V. This value shows the total amount of delta V spent by the spaceship. This parameter is important because there is a limited amount of delta V a spaceship can produce before running out of fuel. The maximum amount of delta V will depend on the spaceship type. At the right, you will see the percentage of the total amount of delta V that has been consumed by the spaceship. In orbit around Earth, this line shows the current status of the spaceship. In this case, it is orbiting the Earth. Distance from Earth. This shows the distance to the surface of the main body the spaceship is orbiting. Escape velocity. This is the speed the spaceship would need, at its current position, to escape the gravitational pull from the planet. Circular velocity. This is the tangential speed the spaceship would need, at its current position, to be into a stable circular orbit. Module of B. This is the total speed of the spaceship, respect to the main body it is orbiting. VR. This is the radial speed of the spaceship, that is the speed in the direction to the main body it is orbiting. VT. This is the tangential speed of the spaceship, that is the speed in a direction perpendicular to the main body it is orbiting. Now, let's put the spaceship into a stable orbit. At the bottom right of the screen, you will see the spaceship direction button. Tap it so it will provide some controls to help you maneuver the spaceship. Now you will see some buttons to select the orientation of the spaceship. This button is used to select a retrograde orbit around the target. This one selects a prograde orbit around the target. This selects an outward direction away from the target. This one selects an inward direction to the target. This selects a backward direction, opposite to the current speed. This selects a forward direction, the same as the current speed. This button is used to lock the current direction of the spaceship. This one is used to free the spaceship direction. The spaceship will face in the same direction as the camera. You can manually change the target with the button at the left of the spaceship direction button, but that is mostly useful for interstellar trajectories only. By default, the target will always be the same object the spaceship is orbiting. At the bottom of the screen, you will also see two indicators. One is an arrow indicating the current direction in which the spaceship is moving. The other is an artificial horizon to get an idea of the position of the planet. The best way to put a spaceship into a stable orbit is to select a prograde or retrograde direction and turn on the engines until you reach the right speed. In this case, I will select a prograde orbit. Now we will turn on the engines with the engine button at the right of the screen. As long as you tap that button, the engines will be activated and the spaceship will keep accelerating at 9.8 meters per second squared. You can also use the button just above the engine button to make the activation permanent until you tap that button again. This level of acceleration is usually too slow, so you may want to use the time slider to make the spaceship accelerate faster. You will notice that two new parameters have appeared at the left part of the screen, periapsis and apoapsis. These parameters will always be shown unless the eccentricity of the orbit is too high. Periapsis is the minimum distance from the planet of the current orbit. Apoapsis is the maximum distance from the planet of the current orbit. Now we can zoom out to have a clear view of the spaceship trajectory. You can use the time slider to increase the time speed, but since the trajectory will be continuously recalculated in real time, there will be a limit at how fast the time can be accelerated. If you try to put the time speed too fast, it will be automatically lowered if required by the trajectory calculation. This concludes this tutorial. Check the other tutorials for additional information.